Hey guys, I am back with a new video. In today's video, I am checking out RuneScape 3 or RuneScape Online. It's basically the new RuneScape, not the old scale RuneScape, and it came out on mobile, globally launched both on iOS and Android, I think a week ago now. So I waited a little bit for it to get a little bit more optimized before I checked it out, but I'm going to be giving a full mobile review. I'm not going to be playing it on PC because this game has been out on PC for many, many years. And it's recently launched on mobile, so I'm going to be doing a mobile review. I'm here on my mobile device and I'm going to be playing out the game and letting you guys know if it's worth playing or not. If it's your first time here, it won't be a last. Make sure you give me a like and subscribe. Guys, we went from having 5% of you guys subscribe to 10% to 13%. Can we reach 20%, guys? Can we just hit that sub button? I really appreciate it. And let's jump right into today's video. So off the bat, I want to start with the server. So if you guys don't know how RuneScape works, basically you can switch between any servers at any time. And the nice thing about it is there's, again, the more active servers, and there's those that are less active. If you are looking to grind some monsters, there's a lot of people that you can just switch server. There's also, like, for me, I am from Norway, so I can go for like a Norwegian server and basically go play it. Now, the thing about RuneScape, guys, is RuneScape has been around for a long time, but they released a newer version of the game, and this game has a lot of content, which I'm going to be going through. But so far on the mobile launch, it is tap to move just like the PC game, and you can basically use your skills on the side, but they added a nice sidebar for skills on mobile, so you can actually tap to move, because, you know, on PC you have to actually use a different kind of sidebar on the right. So they made it very mobile friendly when it comes to using skill. Now, when it comes to optimization on mobile, I have to say there's definitely places you can improve some optimization. I see that sometimes the game doesn't run as fluid, or it doesn't react to my clicking as good, but I think over time they will get it better when it comes to optimization for the game. Now, content wise, I don't think you will find any game on mobile that has more content than RuneScape. The reason for that is this game has a lot of content, and listen closely, guys, I don't usually promote this at all, or promote you guys spending money on any kind of MMORPG on mobile, but if you guys are looking to actually get invested in RuneScape and actually play it, I highly recommend you guys to get the membership. The reason for that is simple. The RuneScape membership is basically, because the game is free, you don't pay a single dime. But if you buy the membership, which is a monthly fee basically, you can unlock a lot of parts of the world. You guys can see this. There's a lot that is unlocked, and most of the good content and gear and stuff is unlocked behind the membership. Now, you can play it for free too, of course, and then maybe if you enjoy it, you can dive in deeper. But if you're looking to play it like a fun game, definitely go for the membership on the game. And this is me always saying don't spend any money on mobile games, but you guys should definitely check it out. Now, when it comes to what you can do in this game, is a lot. On the side here, you guys can see that I have a lot of skills that I can do. Now I'm doing woodcutting and training my woodcutting skills, and you can get any skill up to level 99, and when you get 99, you get a nice achievement and a nice cape, and you can do so much stuff, guys. You can do anything from fishing to alchemy to, you know, crafting to woodcutting to hunting, and you can focus, you can make your character just a farmer or a fighter or just a hardcore PvP grinder. It's all up to you and how you manage your skills and your time in this game. Now, this game is huge, and they have a PK, player versus player style game, which you can do. There's a lot of different events you can do around in the game. And overall, the only thing I do not like, guys, about the mobile version is that it is cross-platform with PC that I have been playing for a while. I wish they made, again, the RuneScape just for mobile players, and that way you didn't have to like play versus PC players, the people that have been playing for a while. But again, it is a fun experience, a fun time to play RuneScape. Now, if you guys know a little bit about my history, my first MMORPG and the reason for this channel was RuneScape. Old school RuneScape, I used to play it like 15 years ago, probably. I don't even know at this point. Super young, and all the experience I gained throughout MMOs and MMOs I enjoyed was through RuneScape. So it is, again, it is a little hard to get used to for most MMORPG players these days because the graphics are a little outdated and the gameplay is a little outdated. You know, it's tap to move and you have to kind of get used to the movement, because when you, for example, fight in battles, you kind of want to tap attack and then tap move and tap attack and tap move. So it is a little, you know, it takes a little getting used to, but once you get used to it, it is a very fun experience. I know a lot of people have been comparing it to Albion Online because I've been making some videos on Albion Online, and Albion Online is a great and amazing gaming experience. But when it comes to Albion Online, it is more PvP focused, I must say. While RuneScape kind of includes everything there is to see in the game. You have everything from, you know, they even have like agility and parkour stuff in this game. So if you're looking for like a more overall MMORPG experience where you have a little bit of everything, definitely check out RuneScape. And you know, try to look away from the, you know, the tap to move. Now again, when it comes to my mobile, I'm playing on a really strong mobile device, the iPhone, and I'm playing on the power saving settings right now, and I'm guessing that's why there's so much fog around and I can't see much. Now this can get very interesting if you ever fight players in if you ever fight players that are playing on PC, right, and you get this and you have all this fog and they don't, you're probably gonna lose pretty hard. And again, when it comes to clicking, I'm kind of struggling with clicking on the phone, and I really hope they fix this optimization. But overall, you know, it's gonna be a great experience. And RuneScape is always a game I would recommend, and I'm so glad they finally released it on mobile. And this just opens the door for so many more MMOs. Honestly, the next thing that I'll be waiting for on mobile is basically WoW. That, like, WoW is going to be coming soon, most likely, to mobile. When we see games like RuneScape, Wild Rift, and all these games coming out, you know, it's going to be a good experience. And I'm so glad that they're making kind of optimizations, like having a skill bar for skills and trying to optimize the game. The one thing I really want to complain about on this game is the close button, the X. It's very hard to hit and sometimes it glitches out and bugs out. But other than that, I don't have any complaints. I like how they did the UI. It looks very clean. When it comes to the UI, it's very, things are very small. You can see the game, you can enjoy it for what it is. Now I'm most likely gonna be playing RuneScape a little bit more and checking it all out, and the RuneScape experience. And but if it's your first time guys playing this game, give it some time, guys. That's the only thing I can say about RuneScape. When you're new to this game, everything is, this, a lot of stuff happening, right? A lot of stuff happening in this game, and the combat and everything is weird, especially if you're used to playing the mobile MMORPGs with the joystick and the auto and everything. It's gonna be a little hard to adjust to because there is no auto, it is super grindy. And especially on mobile, I gotta be honest, the tap to move isn't as fluid as I want it to be, as it would be on PC. I feel like I have to click more than I actually have to. So that is unfortunate. So it will get a little time to get used to, but once you guys used to, guys, this RuneScape experience, you guys will never forget it. You will have so much fun in this game and enjoy it for what it is. There's so much to do and so much to experience. So definitely check out RuneScape, guys, if you haven't. And for those that are playing RuneScape and want to play it on mobile, it is a great way to play it when you're not at your computer. I think they can do a little bit better on the optimization, but it is not bad for what it is. Now that is it for my RuneScape mobile review. Overall experience, I have to say, for being RuneScape and for being for what it is, being tap to move, you know, being different in its own way, I have to give the mobile version 8 out of 10. It is a complete free-to-play. You're not gonna see any pay-to-win in this game for being a mobile game. There's a lot of content, and especially after the subscription, you can unlock so much more. But I'm giving the mobile. I will probably give like the RuneScape overall like a 9 out of 10. But the mobile version, I gotta give it an 8, maybe even a 7 for now until they optimize it a little bit more. But content-wise, this game is great. That is it for my RuneScape review, guys. If it's your first time here, it won't be your last, guys. Give me the like and give me the sub. I really appreciate it. And I will see you guys very soon. Bye-bye.